11 News reporter Kerry Cavanaugh is live in the studio with details. Kerry?
Disturbing details about George Huguely's past continue to stream out as Yeardley Love's family and friends prepare to pay their final respects here in Maryland. On the surface, Yeardley Love and George Huguely looked like a good match. Both fourth-year students on the verge of graduation, both standouts on the University of Virginia's powerhouse lacrosse teams. The picture changed dramatically early Monday morning when Love's body was found beaten face down on her bed. Within hours, Huguely was charged with her murder. Police revealed Thursday that they did not get to the 6'2", 209-pound suspect fast enough to run a blood alcohol test. And alcohol appears to be a common denominator in Hughley's past run-ins with the law. An officer near Washington and Lee University tasered Huguely in 2008 because she said he became abusive when she tried to arrest him for public intoxication.
He became more aggressive, more physical toward me, started calling me several other terms that I'm not going to state now.
As a result, Huguely served 50 hours of community service at the Charlottesville Food Bank, a sentence which never came to the attention of his lacrosse coach or university officials.
We need to look hard at what can we do better going forward.
UVA is now calling for more communication between law enforcement and public universities. Virginia's governor agrees.
We want to do everything possible to keep our campuses safe. I've had two out of my three kids have gone to Virginia colleges. I've got two more getting ready to go. And so I've got a very strong personal interest as well in keeping our campuses safe.
Huguely's trouble with police started at the age of 19. He was charged with possession of alcohol by a minor in West Palm Beach, where his family owns this summer home. A year later, police were called out to a heated fight between Huguely and his father on a fishing boat. Officers say Huguely jumped into the ocean and had to be rescued by a passing boat. It's unclear what Love knew about Hughley's past, but his brutal rage took away her future, according to police.
Yeardley Love's UVA lacrosse teammates took the field today for their first practice since her death. They'll take time off tomorrow and Saturday to attend her funeral. Meanwhile, the Love family has established two memorial scholarships in Yeardley's name. One is at her high school, Notre Dame Prep. Another, set up through the University of Virginia's lacrosse program, has already grown to six figures. Reporting live in the studio, I'm Kerry Cavanaugh, WBAL TV 11 News.
Friends and family are invited to gather for a viewing tomorrow at the Ruck Funeral Home in Towson from 2 to 4 p.m. and again from 7 to 9 p.m. Love's funeral will be held Saturday morning at 10 at the Cathedral of Mary Our Queen. A private burial will follow. For more information, we've posted the arrangements on our website, WBALTV.com. Just click on local news.